First, it's the Bieber. Boy, those were the good old days, weren't they? I just checked TMZ's homepage. There are 76 mentions of Justin Bieber's name there this morning. None of them flattering. And TMZ's not alone. Television networks, websites, they've all been buzzing about Bieber ever since the pop star was taken into custody on Thursday morning.
Pop superstar Justin Bieber has been arrested.
Police say the young star failed a field sobriety test.
Here he's smiling in his mugshot.
Congresswoman, let me interrupt you just for a moment. We've got some breaking news out of Miami. Stand by if you will. Right now in Miami, Justin Bieber has been arrested on a number of charges. The judge is reading the charges, including resisting arrest and driving under the influence.
Now, that's one way to cover it, but for others in the media, avoiding the story and making sure you knew they were avoiding the story was just as tempting. Check out this graphic on the bottom of the screen on the new cable channel Fusion. It says insignificant breaking news.
You think Bieber and you think figures like Gandhi, Mother Teresa, or Beyonce. I mean, he's a gift to us delivered from Canada. And does anyone really want to live in a world where Justin Bieber can be arrested?
Now, Al Jazeera drag raced everybody to the high road by mentioning Bieber's name just once all day on Thursday. Now, to me, this is all about proportion and tone. So who got it right? Who got it wrong? Joining me in New York, James Poniewozik of Time Magazine, and here in Washington, Dorsey Shaw of BuzzFeed. Dorsey, who did get it right? Who had the right proportion and tone in this coverage the last few days?
Well, from a cable news standpoint, I cover cable news, so the way that I looked at it, it seemed like Fox News kind of covered it the right amount of proportion. You know, they covered it with minute little hits, like kind of teasing segments that seemed to never come. And, you know, CNN definitely led the charge. It's expected because, you know, there's a very public push for entertainment coverage with CNN. And so I was actually expecting more coverage from CNN. You know, when you look at the...
You mean more than there actually was?
Yeah, I was expecting...
So you think there was some restraint on the part of the press?
I thought there was some restraint on CNN's part and on cable news's part, you know. But it was a big story, you know. He's a big celebrity. People either love him or hate him. And if you're a producer for a TV show, a front page editor for a website, or a social media editor, you know, you have to know that people are going to be interested in this story either way. So you're going to go with it.
James, did you expect even more coverage than there was?
I wasn't surprised that CNN went into overdrive on this, because I do think that there is a strategy lately at CNN of, if something is, you know, is trending on social media and so forth, then we're going to go into overdrive on it. You know, and I think the problem with that is that you start to look very blatantly like we are just going to let Google Trends be our editor and just go into overdrive on whatever is, you know, for the next 5 minutes really hot right now.
I want to read a few of the Twitter messages. You and I were talking, me and Dorsey were talking on Thursday. Here are a few of the messages that really stood out to me with viewers reacting. The first says, of course, this is from the fake newsroom account of Will McAvoy. It says, arguments against. It has literally no impact on the day-to-day lives of anyone outside fans. He called it paparazzi porn. Here's somebody else. I hate it when people dismiss celebrity stories as fluff. Bieber is a public figure. He's part of the culture. Media is just doing its job. Here's another person. Sorry, but 300,000 people going a week or more without water in West Virginia has received only minimal coverage. Here's a fourth. Networks wouldn't cover it if people didn't watch or read about it. I dislike the coverage, but it's what viewers ask for. I saw a lot of those comments on Thursday. Someone said this. This is a brief in local newspapers, nothing more, but there's zero such constraints on the web. Here's one more. For millions, Justin Bieber is their Michael Jackson. The coverage is expected and the coverage is appropriate. And here's the last one I want to put up on screen. It's from the editor of an app called Breaking News. It says, give users the controls. Let them decide what's breaking news to them, like we do in the Breaking News app. And Dorsey, I wonder if that's where we're going. You know, on the internet, you can decide what to mute or what to highlight. You can decide if you want to hear Bieber's name at all or not. Do you feel like that's going to become more and more commonplace on the internet?
On the internet, yes. I mean, it's like that already. On cable news, you know, there were two...
Not so much.
Yeah, there were two networks who very publicly, you know, claimed, we're not going to cover this, you know, Fusion and Al Jazeera. And
right.
It's strange that Fusion went with that. You know, their whole push is to, like, cut, like bring news to younger people, you know, and you'd think that younger people are going to be more interested in this Bieber story than, you know, just about anybody.
Hey, James, was that a marketing stunt, you think, for Al Jazeera and Fusion to basically dismiss this story as fluff?
Well, I mean, I can't get inside their heads. I think that there can be a value proposition as establishing yourself as, you know, a serious network that doesn't cover stupid news just because it's going to get ratings. By the way, a value proposition that I think that CNN has also and has identified in the past. I mean, there is, leaving ratings aside, there is a business, you know, dollars and cents value to CNN to be perceived as the serious news network that, you know, you can respectably show in public. It's why it does so well internationally, why it does so well digitally, why, you know, they show CNN in airport and hotel lounges. And one risk here, besides the issue of, you know, actually informing the public the way journalism is supposed to, is that to chase, you know, sort of short-term ratings, you can undercut that long-term credibility.
So when people say there's important things at play here, like, you know, the danger of drag racing, do you think that's pretty legitimate or not?
I mean, you know, it's a story. Look, I'm a TV critic. My career is premised on the idea that, you know, pop culture entertainments actually are important. And I think there are, you know, I think that there was cultural value to, you know, the Miley Cyrus twerking story when everybody was talking about that. There were actual, you know, cultural signifiers being played with and where, you know, is society going and so forth. The question is, it's a story. But it's not the story. It's a celebrity DUI. You know, it was not the O.J. Simpson murder case.
I think I agree with what Greta Van Susteren wrote on her blog. Let's put it up on screen. She said, watch for those in the media who cover Justin Bieber by doing segments about how awful the media is covering Justin Bieber. That's the oldest trick in the book. That's exactly what anchors do when they want the celebrity ratings, but they think it'll tarnish their images to do the story.
Yep.
And I hear us, Dorsey, I hear us saying it's not awful that they're covering Justin Bieber, but it's about the amount. It's about the proportion.
Right. And I, you know, I've criticized CNN about coverage, like going way over the top with, you know, like the cruise ship, the poop ship.
Watch out. There's another cruise ship out there now that's having trouble near Puerto Rico.
I've been seeing, you know, teases for that, you know, and that was kind of overkill, you know. And if you, you know, you want to look back at the first day that the Christie story broke, the bridge story, I mean, it was almost double, I mean, more than double the amount of time CNN, MSNBC covered that story compared to the Bieber story.
Dorsey, you live in the internet, I feel like. I see you tweeting every day. I want to put up a few memes on screen because what was amazing about the Bieber story on Thursday to me was how fast these funny pictures and memes spread online. One showed a little kid, you know, pretending to be pulled over by cops. How does this happen online? How is it the web reacts so fast to these stories?
Well, I mean, Jenna Wortham at the New York Times had a story the other day talking kind of about this, like how Twitter is becoming almost like a soapbox where people try to elbow each other out to, like, be the loudest.
To have the best joke.
Exactly, yeah. You know, and, you know, she was not too happy about that. But, you know, that's the way it is with Twitter, you know. It's kind of comic relief, you know. If you're sitting there all day, which, you know, most news people are, watching Twitter, you know, you'd want to have a good laugh, you know. And so
maybe the cable news needs to bring a little bit of that more onto the screen and have some fun, too.
I mean, it's totally possible, you know. It's all there, ready to go.
Dorsey, thanks so much. James, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks a lot, Brian.